In today's video, we're going to be swinging for the fences as we have a look at the McFarlane Toys Walking Dead Lucille Take It Like a Champ edition. Now, many of you may remember that I've already had a look at Lucille, but it was the non-bloodied version. I couldn't consider myself a true Walking Dead fan without also getting the bloodied version of Lucille, and I picked it up over on Zavvy, a really neat website. They have an extensive range of products, including prop replicas, figurines, t-shirts, collectibles, and more. I'll put the link down below, and also, if you want to follow them over on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, I'll put all that information down below. But needless to say, this is the Walking Dead Take It Like a Champ edition, and I'm glad they didn't call it the variant version of Lucille. No, instead they call it Take It Like a Champ. This bat measures 32 inches in length, and don't worry, we're going to also do a comparison with the non-bloody version that I've had a look at previously. Obviously, before we do a comparison between this and the non-bloodied version, we're going to have a look at this really neat looking replica first. We're going to go ahead and remove the obvious noticeable thing about the bat is the sticker that says not a toy. I can't help but chuckle the fact that any parent would have picked this up for a kid. Although, you know what, I have to kind of retract my statement on that. It's a pretty neat looking bat. I mean, there is weight to it. A child could do some damage, despite for the fact it is not really made out of wood. But I mean, it does have some weight to it. So I can understand, obviously, why they had to put it's not a toy. I sort of just kind of giggle loudly when I see that. Okay, so having a look at the Take It Like a Champ version of Lucille. It's essentially the exact same bat as what we have seen before, but you can probably see right off the bat, yes, I'm here all night, that there's excessive amounts of blood that are caked all over the bat. Most, if not all of it, is already wrapped away and coverings, just soaking the very end of it, which obviously is going to make the most impact to whatever Negan decides to be swinging the bat at, probably Abraham or Glenn. Down here, though, it still does have a fair bit of blood. You can see how the blood probably has trickled its way down to the handle portion and probably has gone onto the fingers of Negan in the process. Some nice little small touches I like about it is that they've given these little fingerprint markings. You can almost even see where the blood has smeared its way as he's kind of mishandled the bat a couple of times. Of course, most of the action is happening way, way up here, wrapped around the barbed wire that makes its way completely around Lucille. Don't worry. It is made of a soft plastic, the same material that the regular version of Lucille had. McFarlane Toys has done a pretty good job, actually, of simulating the look of the barbed wire. And within the barbed wire, you can see that there's all these little ringlets in which the barbed wire has been hammered against the bat. The bat is comprised of plastic. I mean, obviously, I think there you can buy wood versions of Lucille, which is basically just like a regular Louisville Slugger-style bat, and then fake, you know, barbed wire wrapped around this. But this is obviously the most direct-to-market retail release version of Lucille. And it does actually look like it looks pretty good. It's got a good hefty weight to it. I actually even thought at one point I wasn't going to be able to fit it all on camera, but sure enough, it prevails, and I'm able to at least get all of it, hopefully, showing on the camera. Some little markings here, of course, is the main oval-shaped burn. I believe this is a burn mark that is around the front section there of the bat. It's only on the one side. It's got some nice grain work that they've also managed to integrate into the bat itself. And it does look, for the most part, like a bat. Really, kind of the giveaway, the dead giveaway, no pun intended. For this bat not to look real is the fact that it's got the separation there of where this was attached. I guess it was comprised of two parts, the front half and then the bottom half, and then they've just put the two together. I'm wondering why they did that, and part of me started thinking, I wonder if they deliberately seamed it as two parts so that if you looked at it, you would have a little bit more of a giveaway that it wasn't a real bat because it had that little seam line happening right there. The bat has a nice coloring stain almost to it, and I'm not just talking about the blood either. I guess one better of what they could have also done to the bat is added some additional organs and tissues and stuff hanging off the bat. That may very well have pushed the line on how gruesome this bat potentially could have been. Instead, they've just decided to give it a full saturation of blood. The blood, even it does a nice job down here where you can see it's just been splattered against the side of the bat right here. Like I said, it's got a good bit of weight to it. I feel as if it is the exact same weight. Obviously, we'll bring in the other one in a second, but I do feel like it's the exact same weight, not as a regular bat, but certainly as the other bat that we've already had a look at. So here's the Take It Like a Champ version of Lucille, and here's the regular version of Lucille right here. Now, I have to admit, when I picked up this one right here, I never really thought about picking up the bloodied version. I might have even said that over the course of that review, that I was perfectly fine with just this version of Lucille. Now that I've actually seen the bloodied version, it definitely looks a little bit more realistic. The grain is about the same, but I think where it looks and adds that little extra bit of depth to it is the fact that it's got all this extra blood on it. It does give it such much more realistic look to it that I think the original one, now that I'm looking at the two bats, simply just doesn't have. I love the fact that they did release two different versions, because if you wanted to have just a regular non-bloodied version of Lucille, you can certainly do that. And then if you wanted more banged up, not so much on Lucille's part, but certainly whoever it's been hitting, you have the bloodied version to go there as well. And just in case you are wondering, it seems as if the weights are exactly the same between the two. There's no difference. I'm also kind of looking at the barbed wire. The barbed wire, I would imagine, based the way it's wrapped around these two bats, I don't think there's a specific pattern that they're doing when they wrap these on. I think they just wrap it and continue wrapping it around the bat, and then they call it a day. Because like this one right here, the clean version of Lucille has a much sparser, it seems, level of barbed wire. Although the wrappings are probably the same, it looks like it's spread out a little bit further on this one than on the bloodied version. Also to know as well, if you own pets, as I certainly do, one thing that the Lucille is a magnet for is hair. The hairs seem to get caught and woven around the plastic of the barbed wire. And often at times, if you're just having this sitting, leaning against the wall with this being on the bottom of the floor, a lot of times I'll pick this bat up and just kind of spend a few minutes or so picking the hairs off, because like I said, the hairs are really prone to getting trapped amongst the barbed wire right here. Looking at the two bats, again, I really wasn't expecting to get both versions of them. I was perfectly really content with getting this one. But then the more and more I saw this version, and of course, as we are now entering into the final days of Rick Grimes, it got me thinking, you know what, I really wanted to pick up the bloodied version of Lucille, and luckily I was able to find it over on Zavvy. You know, I was such a big fan of the non-bloodied version of Lucille that I didn't think I needed this one. Yet, comparing the two, this one looks a lot more realistic. It's funny because the bats themselves, the coloring are the same. The grain are almost identical, if not identical, to one another. And just shy of the way that they've wrapped the barbed wire is sort of identical as well. So it really boils down to paint, and just goes to show that a little bit of blood, a little bit of guts, and a little bit of brains smeared across Lucille in paint only definitely makes this one look a lot more realistic. You still can't get past the fact that there is that big noticeable seam from the bottom or three quarters of the way down the handle, but still it's a pretty close replica of the Lucille that Negan swings around in The Walking Dead. If you guys want to pick this one up for yourself, I'll put the link down below to Zavvy. This is where I picked it up for myself. They have a wide, like I said, a wide, extensive range of different prop replicas and other cool collectibles. So if you are interested in picking up the Take It Like a Champ edition of Lucille and didn't get your chance before like this guy did, you can click the link down below and order yours directly from Zavvy. Today, we were having a look at the McFarlane toys. This was the Walking Dead. Take it like a champ, Lucille. Looking pretty cool. Just a little bit of blood goes to show. If you guys haven't had a chance to hit that little subscribe button down below, what are you waiting for? More videos will be coming your way. And certainly, if you want to go back and have a look at some of my other Walking Dead reviews, there's a whole playlist just for Walking Dead. That includes six scale figures and other collectibles, all within the range of the walkers. Not literally, because you don't want to be in the range of the walkers, but you know what I mean. Also, while you're at it, why not swing by the homepage? Check out some of the videos that have been posted up there and see if there's anything you may have missed along the way. More videos will be coming your way, guys. So as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.